What if what we call public opinion was just a manufactured narrative that makes it easier to convince people that if their views are different, then there's something wrong with that, or there's something wrong with them?
Spending is a tax. As soon as the government spends money, eventually it's a tax. Sometimes we put a direct tax on the people, sometimes we borrow the money, and sometimes we print the money.
Freedom and the dignity of the individual have been more available and assured here than in any other place on earth.
The Patrick Riggins Show. And now your host, Patrick Riggins.
Oh, yes. Mr. Daniels is correct. No, not Jack. Charlie. Don't start betting on America falling just yet. Increasingly, though, the Russians aren't our problem. Nor are the Egyptians. Not even Al-Qaeda, the biggest problem in this country. And it's one that literally keeps growing exponentially. The biggest problem we're facing in this country is our own government. Talking to the people in Congress, your employees, by the way, they stand there with this stupid look on their face and tell us, oh, hey, there's nothing they can do about it. Well, it's government. We don't know what to do. It's too big to fix. We can't get anything reversed. Sorry, Congress people. Those excuses aren't going to fly anymore. I don't care which side of the aisle you're on, Republican, Democrat, everyone up there needs to shape up, or we need to start flushing these people out of office. I guess the question is, are you tired of this yet, America? Are you tired of being lied to? Are you tired of being told, oh, there's nothing we can do about Obamacare, or we can't slow down the spending in Washington, or we can't pull our soldiers out of whatever country name you want to insert in there? We're in just about all of them, so it really doesn't matter which one you name. We probably shouldn't be there in the first place. But back to my question, are you getting tired of being treated like a child, or even worse, some sort of simpleton that doesn't know when they're being lied to? Are you tired of Congress passing all of this unconstitutional legislation, but then pointing their fingers at the bureaucracy or the administration when you call them out on it? Oh, no, we're not screwing you. It's the administration. It's this agency. It's that agency. It's these faceless bureaucrats. Hey, we're not dumb out here. We know it's you passing the laws in the first place. You're the ones authorizing all these shenanigans. Hey, speaking of our soldiers in foreign countries, did you read on Friday where we're opening back up our embassies? Well, except for Yemen, we aren't opening that one back up. Oh, and the consulate in Pakistan. Although they say they're keeping that one closed on account of a separate threat. So what are we supposed to get from all this? Do the terrorist ammunition not work after this week? I mean, does it have an expiration date on it? Yeah, if we can just make it through the next 7 days, their guns and bombs won't work after this week. We'll be safe if we can just stick this one out one more week. Is the administration this stupid? Or do they think we're this stupid? Or do they think the terrorists are this stupid? If the terrorists are bent on attacking us, will they not do it next week after the embassies are back open? I'm going to be honest with you, as you've come to expect me to be. If this is how we're thinking, it's no wonder we have the problems we do. This kind of thinking is absolute lunacy. Hey, I think someone might be trying to break into my house this week, so I'm going on vacation for 7 days. By the time I get back, those burglars won't be wanting to break into my house anymore. Well, won't they just do it after you come back home? No way! They only want to do it this week. By next week, they'll be over it. They'll have decided to move on to something else. This whole embassy closures mess has people speculating whether it was even warranted or not. Do we really have information about this? Or is it all a ruse to support the argument for continued NSA spying. We've not had any attacks. Is it because we took action? Or is it because nothing was going to happen anyway? Well, who knows? And that's the whole problem. They are really damned if they do, damned if they don't. So we close embassies and nothing happens, or we leave them open and something happens. Either way, the government is going to get blamed. See, you closed the embassies and nothing ever came of it. You were just crying wolf. Or on the other side of the coin, see, you left the embassies open and we had a rocket attack or a bomb. Why didn't you close them? This is the problem for the government, and it's purely its own making. The reason for this is we, the citizens, the bosses of government, in case you've forgotten, they work for us, not the other way around. But the reason for all these questions is because we can't trust what the government's telling us. It's lied one too many times. Anything it says is immediately suspected of being untrue. This is because of the many lies it's told us in the past, these constant violations of our constitutional rights. And we sit out here and wonder, who's going to stand up for us, the American citizens? Are we just going to have to take care of this ourselves? Now, personally, I don't believe that's the best answer to our problems, but unfortunately, it seems if it's becoming the only one. We elect people, essentially hire them to go to Washington and start straightening things out, but they end up being corrupted by the very system we sent them to fix. This lure of money and power is just too great. Too many of these people can't resist it. Not only in Congress, but all of Washington, and even government down to the state and local levels. The abuses of power don't only exist in the federal government, it exists in all levels of government. Sometimes the very people who want to be in government are the ones who don't need to be there. It's almost like we as citizens, we should have to drag someone kicking and screaming into office. Only then do we know we have the right person for the job, someone who doesn't want to be there. The only problem with that is these types of people don't run for office. They have no desire to tell other people what to do, to try and run other people's lives. But they're exactly the people we need in office, because they'll work to dismantle this dysfunctional leviathan that government has become. Do you ever sit and think and wonder how your life would be different if government just blinked out of existence tomorrow? Would your life really be that different? Or would it actually be a little better? For a little over half of the people in America, life would get better. However, for a little under half of Americans, they wouldn't know what to do, because they depend on government handouts. Which, by the way, if you haven't listened to the show any or in the past, and we get a lot of listeners, a lot of new listeners each week, government handouts are the government taking money from one citizen at the point of a gun and giving it to another in the form of charity. That sounds right to you. It probably doesn't sound right to you, I mean, and it isn't, but these kind of people depend on these handouts to support themselves. Now, for a tiny fraction of these people, they really would be in need. And we have enough charities and churches to take care of them, just like what used to happen. But for the rest of the people who need to go to work, in the long run, they would be better off too. Now, they don't think they'll be better off because they'll be having to work to do something to get paid for so they can buy food and shelter. But in the long run, they'll have this higher self-esteem. They'll feel better about themselves, and they'll have a much better outlook on life. That's what you get when you're working and providing for yourself. All right, this week, we have a lot to get into. So we'll get on into this break and get these commercials run. When we come back, we'll talk about solving a lot of the violence we have occurring in America today. When we come back here on the Patrick Reagan Show on the Libertarian Lighthouse Radio Network and News Talk 98.7 WOKI.